You guys know we don't talk college basketball until we talk to Steve Fisher of San Diego State, the Aztecs head coach. And now we're not going to talk March Madness until we talk to Steve Fisher, San Diego State Aztecs head coach. Steve Fisher, welcome back to Jay Moore Sports. You got to play St. John's, Steve Lavin coach team. Good draw, bad draw, right down the middle. How you looking at it?
Well, the one thing I would tell you, Jay, is we're in the draw. And that's the most important thing. We told our team, you can't catch a fish if you don't get out in the boat and into the lake, and we're there. So we've got an opportunity. St. John's is a formidable opponent. They're very athletic, and it'll be a challenge. But they're supposed to be. We're an 8 seed. They're a 9 seed. It'll probably be a real, real good, close, hard-fought game.
You guys don't play until Friday night late, like 10 o'clock at night on the East Coast. That's one of the last games of the first round. Do you anticipate the guys getting antsy? Do you encourage them to sleep late or the extra film? How do you get these guys prepared to wait around that long, Coach?
Well, we'll probably get them up a little later. I haven't even given it that much thought. I do know that we're playing late on the East Coast time, which is about prime time on the West Coast. So we're playing a 7 o'clock game East Coast or West Coast and a 10 o'clock game back East, and we'll be okay on that. We've had to do that before, so I think we'll adjust and adapt to that. That's not my biggest issue. My biggest issue is being able to make a shot or two. When we do, we're really good, and when we don't, we score 43 points like we did against Wyoming.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. A low-scoring team, I think it's 62, 61 thereabouts points a game. You have a really big front court, 6'8", 6'8", 6'10". Obviously, any Steve Fisher coach team is going to be very defensive, defensively minded. You explained to me last time you were on, missed free throws, offensive rebound, and putbacks. You guys actually led maybe the country in that statistic that you actually created because of how often you do it. Very long question, and I apologize, and I'll get right to it, Coach Steve Fisher. How is it frustrating when shots aren't going down? Do you think I've recruited the wrong people? When you recruited these guys, they're probably hitting everything. That's why they're on the team, right?
Well, you preach make the right play, and the right play for you may not be the right play for me. If you're a good shooter, we want you to shoot it. If you're a guy that's better off the bounce, we want you to do that. And we've done a pretty good job of that. The Wyoming game, Jay, we knew going in it was going to be low scoring. We had in that game, I had us down for 49 possessions. I think Ken Pomeroy, who does it better than anybody, had the game only 47 offensive possessions. It's tough to score when you're on defense and they're running that shot clock into the red a lot. And we had that problem. We only had 6 second half field goals, so we had some good shots that we didn't make. Going right down to the very last two plays, we got the ball, Jay, down one or down two with a minute to go. Took a timeout and wanted to go a la NBA style. We wanted a 2-for-1. Put the ball in J.J. O'Brien's hands. He came off a high ball screen, got it right to the rim, and they came over, but we missed one right at the rim. We stopped them and hold them. We get what we call early offense. We come down at Keo Quinn. We're 3-on-2. He has a wide-open three-pointer to basically win the game for us that doesn't go in. So you have to be able to make shots. I mean, if you're not gonna win scoring 43 points. And rarely will you win scoring 45, which is what Wyoming got. We've had games and halves where we shot the daylights out of the ball. We now need to see if we can get that magic, karma, whatever you want to call it,
Jay Moore Sports Mojo.
To go in the NCAA tournament.
It's the Jay Moore Sports Mojo, Coach.
There you go.
Do you fly the kids out early to get accustomed to the time change, or does the NCAA, I remember Buzz Williams had that classic rant where they had to get on a plane and leave right after they won a game because Buzz Williams said, can we go upstairs and get a hamburger and lay down? Are you able to go to Charlotte early, or when do you leave, sir?
We're going to leave Wednesday for a Friday game, which is
okay,
probably
good.
The right thing
yeah.
to do. So we'll get in with plenty of time to adjust, and then you got all the mandatory NCAA obligations. They make you have a 1 hour open practice where basically what all any of us do is we come in and we shoot layups and we do spot shooting. We do a little bit of, you know, half court stuff at each end, but it's basically offense. And we have a practice that same day at another site, which is a closed practice as you do your game planning. So you have to make sure you manage your time, that you don't wear them out in terms of wear their legs out by being on the floor 2.5 hours the day before you play a game this late in the season. So there's adjustments that have to be made. The nice thing about us, this is our sixth straight year in the tournament, so we've got a lot of players that have been there before that are used to the routine, and I think we'll adjust okay.
Coach Steve Fisher, San Diego State Aztec men's basketball head coach. I want to repeat something back to you, Coach, because you and I are friends, and sometimes in the carnival that is life, we don't realize what's going on right in front of us. We don't see the forest through the trees. You just said out loud, this is our sixth straight trip to the tournament, and I just wanted you to take a second and realize this is your sixth straight trip to the tournament, and I just wanted you to realize you're an amazing success, my man.
I appreciate you saying that, Jay. We're very proud of the program, I'll underline program, that we have been a part of at San Diego State. It feels good. Our fans and community have embraced this program, and we want it to continue, and we want to grow it. And, you know, right now, millions and millions more eyeballs will be on March Madness. So if we can find a way to win in advance and be playing on Sunday and somehow find a way to beat the number one seed probably in a Duke, then you really gain access to more and more people. But just getting in, we're the only school in the state of California that's been six straight years, and I know that there are not over 12 or 15 that have been more than six consecutive years to the programs, to the tournament. So we know that, we're proud of that, and we want to continue it.
My man, Steve Fisher, San Diego State Aztec head coach. They go to Charlotte on Wednesday, Friday, 9:40, but we all know that starts at 10 because they're going to have pregame and the Star-Spangled Banner and all the, you know, balloons and confetti and all that stuff. But when the dust clears and the smoke clears, it will be an 8-seed against a 9-seed, St. John's, coached by Steve Lavin. Not a very good tournament coach, he said about himself. But you know what? I wouldn't read anything into that, and I would just crash those boards, brother. The big man's out. Take advantage of it.
We're going to do that, Jay.
Obeka. Chris Obeka.
Compete like our hair's on fire.
Chris Obeka from St. John's suspended. The big man's out. Crash the boards, coach.
Well, I'm hoping that we get a couple. I hope I feel badly that they don't have their full complement of players, but we've got to make sure that we do what we need to do to give ourselves the best chance to be successful against them.
Jay Moore Sports Mojo. But look, you've been successful long before you ever met me. I'm just proud that we're friends. And you're just, if I was going to send my kid anywhere to be coached by anybody in any sport, it would be certainly you, Steve Fisher. I thank you always for being my friend and coming on Jay Moore Sports. Always great to talk to you. Best of luck in the tournament. Go kick some butt.
Thank you, Jay. You are a good friend. I remember you had me on. I think your first basketball coach on to start the season, and now I'm proud to say I'm on early with you as we prepare for March Madness and the tournament to the Final Four.
That's it.
Thanks, Jay.
I'm not going to say anything to jinx anything. We just know you're playing St. John's. That's all I know. That's all I know. Thank you, Steve Fisher. See you soon.
I'm with you. Thank you.
There he goes on the Progressive Insurance Celebrity Hotline.